A shiny new era is tiptoeing nearer.
And where do we feature?
Just listen to teach.
Because I can't stand what's happening in this community.
Yes!
Yeah, and somebody has to make a change.
Yes!
Now, brother, will you help me?
Yes! Well,
I wish I could.
Damn it, man, I heard the People's Revolutionary Army was once 1,000 strong. Now, what happened?
They got government jobs.
You know that government office building on 25th Street?
Yeah?
We went down to take it over. But they were hiring that day.
The brothers walked in with guns. And came out with jobs.
The brothers weren't mad anymore.
Family, welcome to this special edition of Irvington Unbound, the official newsletter of the Sheridan St Block Association. I'm your host, Jay, and I hope everything's going great for you. Let's just jump on into it with the plan. The schedule got mixed up, so there is no meeting or agenda information available in this episode, but that doesn't mean there isn't much to discuss. The tax meeting is still a thing. Not attending the latest meetings is what's holding up setting a date on that, but don't worry, guys, I gotcha. After almost 30 episodes and a ton of feedback, there are some things that need to be explained. Unbound is a living and breathing show, much like the Constitution, meaning that the format sometimes changes and we're always looking to evolve. The main focus of this show is news relevant to the township of Irvington, New Jersey. Yet sometimes I can be a bit ambitious in scope and reasoning. A bombing in Mogadishu is a little beyond the borders, so sorry guys. Valley Mall isn't open per se. There is a value zone and pending rainbows set to open on Friday, but the interior is top notch, giving credence to the rumors that there was an upscale vision for the property. Let's be honest, it's doubtful that rainbows and Zales will ever be within 5 feet of each other. But if the community proves it can take care of the nice things it gets, it can get nicer things, you know? There was also a Halloween event. Incredibly charming. I'm just gonna leave the footage in a corner right here. League of Municipalities held their Democrats United event where Mayor Voss kicked off his re-election bid with Charnette Frederick, October Hudley, and Renee Burgess. The election is May 8th, and if there are any challengers, I'd suggest you get to work. For honesty, I'd love to see 4 well-contested races with debates and groveling because that's what the township deserves. You deserve to have your representatives have to kiss your ass in order to get your tax dollars. Debate, run ads, buy billboards, come door-to-door and promise you their only interest is your best interest. Unfortunately, that is highly unlikely due to the organization of the team Irvington Strong Mafia. Oh, and you didn't miss it, read anything. His shirt says Team Irvington Strong versus everybody. And seeing how members of Team Irvington Strong have told me to get out of town, I assume I'm a part of everybody. Let's be very clear. It's nothing personal with any elected official. Mayor Voss has only shown himself to be a good man, yet that doesn't remove him or any council member or any particular person from the scope of scrutiny. And where I have seen plenty to be proud of, the true root of our problems, poverty, doesn't seem to be too high on anyone's priority list. So don't count me impressed. Phil Murphy won the election. As you know, I'm not a fan, but there's always the recreational bud, and that's where we're gonna kick off the meat of this special episode. The drug war has been a plague on our society, particularly in our community. Everyone has messed up drug story that they wouldn't if there was never a drug war to begin with. Now that we're clear on that, I hope you can save your moral posturing for someone still living in 1990. Long and short, cannabis is a billion-dollar industry, and if production and manufacturing took place in urban communities with a standard salary, then we can actually combat poverty and restore the urban working and middle class. How do you set a standard salary, one may ask? Well, that's where the government and your elected officials come in. These buttholes offered Amazon $7 billion to set up shop here. There is definitely a way taxpayers can subsidize the industry either through urban business zones or creating brand new language. The best lawyers are really good at that. To ensure that the funding from those breaks and incentives go towards the salaries of the people working in the industry. You know, the people that's going to need the money the most. What you can envision is a return to the steel mills and coal mines, where it was understood that not everyone was made for college, and there were opportunities to raise a family and make a life for yourself, something that America lost along the way. I'll let my man Rich explain the eventuality of the establishment's method of maintaining corporate profitability.
But it's a very relevant story. I was in college and I was working at Circuit City Express. For those of you who were too young to remember or just didn't know this because it was a long ass time ago, no matter what age you were, Circuit City had mini stores in the mall. And I worked at that store. It was one of the best jobs I've ever had. It was a lot of fun, and the people I worked with were very, very cool people. Long story short, it closed down because Best Buy moved into the mall, and that store had like zero traffic. I mean, there would be days I would go and we would get like a customer, which is really, really bad. So they decided to kill off their Circuit City Express stores in the mall, which kind of was, you know, another sign that Circuit City was in trouble, but whatever. So they transferred me over to the main store because there was literally a real Circuit City right across the street. And there, which I was commissioned to at the Circuit City Express, there was commissioned people working at Circuit City, the main store, that were literally making like $70,000+ a year. They were earning a livable salary where you can pay your mortgage, pay for your kids' tuition, so on and so forth. So you had a very, very knowledgeable, helpful staff that work there because, well, their livelihood is there. And, you know, when you are making good money, it makes you more motivated to work. But something happened. I was around the time that I actually went there. Circuit City decided, especially because Best Buy had a different business model, that they were going to stop commission. There was no more need for commission, and they gave some of the higher earning employees an option to get an hourly wage, which even though some of them got a fairly decent hourly wage, it was nowhere near what they were making. They laid people off and some people just quit altogether. Do you blame them? If you go from making $70,000 a year to $12 an hour, you're not going to be too inclined to stay in your position.
And that, my friends, is the danger of corporatism. And we need to get back to ensuring that those of us who have the least still have a shot at a decent life. Because that's what will make life better for everyone else. So where do you feature? Well, reach out to some of these fine electeds and tell them that, hey, we need a plan in place to make sure that urban communities are benefiting from the marijuana and cannabis industries. So in a quick recap of state news, everyone's getting their transition teams together as the change of power is imminent. New House Speaker and state Republicans are looking to help Murphy get his first win with the millionaire's tax, but as you know, the state has some really rough economic times ahead. That also plays into the concept that I affectionately call urban equity. If this industry is properly backed, it can create some insulation from hits that we're even currently taking, i.e. the township's budget deficit. Senator Robert Menendez's corruption trial has been called as a mistrial, so congratulations to him. And that's where we're going to leave this video. Thanks so much for watching. Please do all the YouTube things, liking and subbing. Let's have a conversation in the comments. Do you see the vitality and the ability of this idea? Do you have a story of a company legally cutting your pay, either through ending commission or slicing your hours, which will be a big reason the $15 minimum wage won't move anyone out of poverty? Let's talk about it. So until the next video, take care of yourselves and each other. Love.
My position is that the black woman's disrespect and rebellion against the leadership and the authority of the black man is the direct cause of the breakdown in our black family structure. Now, of course, there are many black people who consider those fighting words because as black women, we have never been subject to the kind of examination that our men have been subject to since we have been here. They did not tell us that all of that, being my own person and I'm independent, would lead to separation, loneliness, celibacy, and lesbianism. They didn't tell us that if you give up the man, you're going to take one of these things and it's worse and it will destroy your nation. They didn't give us that information. They made us think that it was some kind of glorified position to brag about the fact that I got my own job, my own credit card, my own car, so I don't need no man. I don't even know how we got that mixed up. Ain't none of that got nothing to do with having being with no man. You know, we have some serious relationship problems that nobody has been able to address us on because everybody wants to pretend that this is not going on. You know, over 60% of our women are single, widowed, separated, or divorced. They don't have a man. I just came out of Florida and they got a housing complex that the Urban League built, which is a black organization that is for women and children only. They say they don't allow any men in there. I didn't have time to deal with it, but I talked about them real bad. That's the silliest program I've ever heard of. You know them women that had men if they got a bunch of children.